Well, it's March 22nd. Oh, it's 23rd, 1995. And today is the big day that we leave the Sorensen estate in Maple Grove. Well, my little kidlets, three guys have been working all day putting your little bedrooms in this great big truck. And I've got a few things in my trailer that they can't take, like the freezer and the lawnmower, which I hope I never have to use again. And we've got the car filled up with plants and Christmas ornaments. And the neighbors are very excited that we're leaving.
I'm so exhausted. I'll be so glad when these people move away. Oh, is the camera on? It's the talking box. Say hello, box. Hello.
Come on, dear. You can show your head.
Yeah, your head's all right. The rest of you isn't so good, but...
Yeah, actually, if the rest of you looked as good as the box. Ooh, I better leave. Well, everything's getting a little empty. Everything's looking pretty empty. Yep. Kind of looks like a business that went out of business. There's nothing left but the phones. Oh, at least our favorite lamp's still here. But that will soon be packed. And here's little Adria's room. Not much left, but her little devil and a Christmas tree. Nessa, you never were good at cleaning your room. And that's still true. Look at all the stuff that was under your bed. And Alexa Genevieve. Yours wasn't too bad. But Mom already did pick up a million candy wrappers. I think I'm gonna miss your little teddy bear border. That was so cute. And your little rainbow from Knott's Berry Farm. The Crayola crayons Mama made. Remember when I used to pull Huggy Bear out from behind the border? Yeah, you had a lot of fun in your little bedroom. Yeah, even the bathroom's been cleaned out. Just think, kids. I remember when all three of you used to take a bath together. Oh, you'd have so much fun, especially if we allowed you to have a bubble bath. Mama's little sewing room is pretty empty. And this used to be the room where we had all those live-ins stay. This was their bedroom. Yeah, here's my old office. This used to be my pride and joy. I had room for all my little toys. My antiques, the photographs, the rockets. And all my beautiful books and records and tapes. Back in the days when I was involved in politics, one of my friends used to call it the bunker. Yeah, we had did a lot of work, had a lot of fun. Well, this was our backyard. Looks pretty brown right now. You can hear the geese. Yeah, this morning I watched a mallard duck and his little wife waddle up to the front yard. We really were lucky. This is probably as close to northern Minnesota as you could come in the cities. Oh, in the summer, this used to be so green and lush. We could go down the South 40, and it would be like we were 100 miles north. Oh, there's the three Scotch pine we planted. One was for Alexa, one was for Adria, and one was for Anessa Kay. Just think, as years go by, they'll get bigger and bigger. Oh, there's the Bakers. Pam and Tom are so nice to us. They had us over last night, our last night in Maple Grove. Oh, there's the bike path. Speak of the devil. She's still watching, holding vigil, ready to phone the neighbors when we're gone.
Still waiting to break out the champagne. I'm gonna limp home.
Thanks, Pam.
Candy knows how to get in.
Okay. Well, with that, we say goodbye, Maple Grove.